In this video, you will learn how to perform a simple scene transition that is reusable and can be implemented once for all of your levels. The scene changer can serve as a great foundation for the limitless type of scene changes that you can perform. Howdy, and welcome to Game Endeavor, where you can learn practical dev skills from an experienced developer. This whole week I've been working on the wall jumping tutorial, but that has turned into quite the behemoth, so we're going to push that back until next week. At the last minute, however, I wanted to show you how we can easily implement some scene transitions. Let's go ahead and get started. I have prepared a scene that we'll use as our scene changer. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using a simple black fade-in, fade-out transition. We want this to affect the entire view, so the root of the scene is a canvas layer with a colored rect control that will black out the screen. I also have an animation player with a single fade-out transition that changes the alpha from transparent to opaque. We want to make sure that the alpha is transparent to begin with, otherwise it'll start out blocking our view. And this script is auto-loaded, so we can call it anywhere in the script calling scene changer. Inside of the script for the scene changer, I have pre-cached the nodes in our scene, as well as a signal that we'll use later. We're going to create a change scene method with path and delay as parameters. I will default delay to 0.5 seconds. We'll call this method when we want to initiate a scene transition. The path parameter is a string for the file path that points to the level you would like to load. And delay is how long to wait before starting to fade, because sometimes you may want to add a little pizzazz before you finish your level. The first thing we'll do inside of this method is to initiate that delay. We're going to use a yield for this, which will cause the method to freeze until we tell it to resume, at which point it will run as the coroutine. We will tell it to resume by using a signal. In this instance, we'll use a timer. Scene trees have a function that allow us to quickly create a timer, so we'll take advantage of that. We'll say yield getTree.createTimerDelay, then pass in the string timeout as a second parameter for yield. Once that initial delay has passed, we will want to start the fade-out animation, which is as simple as calling animationPlayer.playFade. We want to wait until the fade animation has finished, otherwise you will load the scene prematurely. How embarrassing. So we will use the yield function again, only this time instead of a timer, we'll pass to it our animation player. Our animation player has signals too, so we can use those. Specifically, we would like to use the animation finish signal, so pass it as a second parameter. Now, the screen is black, the lights are out, and it's time to tell spooky stories. Have you heard the one about the scene that failed to load? We're going to use getTree.changeScene to handle our scene changing. We'll give to it our path as an argument so that it knows what to load. However, should that scene not exist for whatever reason, then it will put out a tiny little error message. Personally, I like for the bugs that I create to make a grand entrance. ChangeScene returns an error code based on if it was successful. So we'll put this bit of code inside of an assert function, and then check to see if it equals OK. This will cause the game to crash spectacularly, and you can revel in the destruction you have caused as you try to understand why the scene has failed to load. Assuming that you manage to give it a proper scene, then you'll want to start fading back out so that your player can stand in awe at the magnificence of your new level. We can do this by telling our animation player to play fade backwards. This will reverse the animation, and now your new level is revealed. That's pretty much it. However, sometimes you may have a need to brag to your friends and neighbors that you changed the scene. In this case, let us use the yield function with our animation player again. And after that yield finishes, we'll emit our scene change signal. If you would like to learn more practical dev skills, then check out this video here. And if you're new, then join the sub club to get notified for future videos.